All right. For those of you watching on the broadcast, the other day we were working out of Realistic Animals and Acrylic with Lee Hammond. And I'm going to do this monkey here. So I have my sketch on mixed media paper, 140 pounds. Let me pull up the chat so I can see when people get in. This is just an impromptu, so it'll all depend on notifications. I'll turn the volume down. So I have the sketch. I'm not sure I like the size of it. And I had some issues, but this will get covered up. So I'm going to underpaint first. Hi, Kat. Hi, Josie. So this is the goal. And I'm going to start with the skin tones on the hand. And the face. I think all right, so I don't have a flesh tone, so I'm gonna make my own. Hi, Gail. Yeah, it was good. We didn't do anything in particular, we just stayed home, which is always nice. All right, so I noticed that one is a little bit on the lighter side and one is a little bit more golden. So I'm using melon and I'm going to use a little bit of Canyon Orange for this one, the darker one. And I'm going to add a little yellow. Hi, Sherry. Hi, Lori. And then this one, I think I'll just add the melon. Just a little bit, maybe, of that darker color. I'm also going to put a little yellow out just to kind of play with if I need it. Let's find a brush. I have some new brushes. They're just cheap brushes, but it is nice to have new ones. I really like the still going to go back with one of these older ones too a little bit. And I am going to use colored pencil on top. At this point, I still want my lines to show. I have a lot of extra lines because I'm marking where like the darker pigment is, where the shadows are. Yeah, that's my only plan is to watch the marathon and the streaming. Okay, I am going to lighten this. Now this is going to have hair over it. Hi, Elaine. Hi, Mark. I'll fade into the dark there. Well, lurk away. So I made my mix have a little bit more yellow in it. For the face. I didn't tweet that I was going to stream. I did mention it yesterday, so. It may take a while before some of the others. Yes, it's from Paint Realistic Animals in Acrylic by Lee Hammond. And this is the original. I blew it up. And I'm underpainting today. And then what I'll do when I'm watching TV is do the colored pencil work. It's a little too difficult to do some of that. Oh, thank you. It's hard. I gotta get close sometimes. Okay. So I think this needs to go lighter. And let that other darker be my shadows. Oh, Janet doesn't hardly come to my streams on Sunday. I think she gets busy. Okay. And then I'm just going to use a dry brush to kind of feather some of this. And we'll start using multiple brushes. Yeah, I want to see my line work because then I'm going to use colored pencil. And the more I work and add, the less those lines will start to disappear. But right now, I still want to see. I think I need a darker coral color that I have sitting here. Hi, Shauna. How are you feeling today, hon? Any better? I'll get quiet, sorry. This is all deco arts. A lot of it is what they call deco arts tradition, which is a little bit higher grade paint than their Americana. This is my preference, but I am still using some of the Americana, but I really like their traditions line. It also comes in the tubes. The only thing I don't like about the tubes is it kind of plops out, and sometimes you open it and you get more than you want. All right, I'm also going to add a brown, a raw umber. Yeah, it's a relatively new line. Yeah, that's getting a little. Now, one of the things you can do is like paint on your reference photo to see if the color matches what you're trying to do. Not liking that brush. All right, let's try a little smaller. Hi, Gilly. I'm sorry you're not feeling better, Shauna. Now, remember, this is just an underpainting. Thank you. And I'm just going to switch back and forth between brushes. That's better. Now she did the whole thing in acrylics. Yeah, go see that. If you can go see the doctor, though. Sorry, I'm quiet. Okay, so I think I'm good with that hand. For an underpaint, you know, like I said, this is just, this isn't the finished. But each time I add more layer, I lose more of the line. So that'll help me when it's, when I'm trying to meld it. It's hard to, for me to see, to be honest, Sherry. I don't typically film the colored pencils because I have to get so like up on it. Okay. This is a little pinker in here. Lines in, and I'll add some more white back. I'm going to come in with a smaller brush. That's what you just got to push through, Jilly. Like one area, one thing at a time, because you're going to make that big mess. But you can get to the other side, you know? And then it's so rewarding when you do. And I do find it helpful to keep my brush drier and to look in the camera. Yeah. It just, you gotta take breaks. At some point you almost have to like kind of put your head down and kind of plow through. And I will show you, I have this brush that is all messed up, but it's great for scrubbing. So I'm gonna get a blend. Okay, and then I'm going to come in with some water here. There's no telling. Usually she does a calendar project. So I expect she'll do some kind of calendar project, to be honest. Hi, Judy and Judy. I'm just going to end up losing the paper, so I need to go to another area. But I'm happy enough with the start of the hands. I'm going to give myself a little bit of a break from the dark skins or this and start putting in some of the black and the brown gray. And I've just got to put a little raw umber in black to start with. Then we'll switch to more black in a minute. Basically, this left side is kind of indistinguishable. There's hair in here anyway, so I'm going to smudge that line so it's not hard. Like I said, that'll get colored pencil in there. And there'll be dark that goes up in the face that I'm going to start working on here in just a minute. But I want to do the face before I get to, and I'm using the brown and the black. Just want to get rid of this line. And I'm going to take a small brush and get some of that dark area up around the mouth. Wait a minute. Let's put in some of this. So I'm going to get some of that dark color. On this thin brush. I'll just get some of the shadows in there. And then come back in here. Some more of this dark color. And some of that will get minimized. But it's pretty dark in the picture. I need more brown. Thank you, Elaine. Let me pull that down just a little. All right, I'm going to start working on that. Needs to be eliminated, so I need to put a coat, let it dry. Add to it a lot. Some of this won't show when I crop it. I haven't decided what size, other than I want it to be a normal frame size. And this is all black in here too. But I'm going to add Prussian blue to the background so I can distinguish it just a little bit.
Get those back in the water.
So let's get a different brush. Out of the water, and let's go back to the flesh colors. Now there's very little ear actually shown on this side, and there's more light on this side, so I added more ear. In here. But some of that will get. Covered by fur. Okay. And then I should probably take some darker color. Hi, Dot. Thanks, Judy. Hi, Julie. Okay. Then I'm going to come in with some black. Okay, we'll let that dry just a little bit. And we'll come over. And the face is not finished. For those of you who came in. This has way more pink. And again, I'm having to, the ear did not come off that original. A dry brush. Okay. Whew. That's the problem with like thumb drives and those things sometimes is if they break. If you know like your thumb drive is on its last legs, you need to back up copies. Okay. I think that'll be okay when we get the fur and the hair. In that area. I'm going to add a very dark gray to the table because on this side I need some lighter colors. And in the center, I'll need some lighter colors. I'll get in there.
shadow kind of in here.
Okay, and let's take
and scrub that kind of. Hi, Kathy. Okay. Hi, Joe.
Okay. Need a break from the face again. Added some of that gray in there. So it's not as dark right now. Okay. All right. Okay, let's try. It's not what I want. I'm trying to get an eye color. I'll make Dot happy. Okay. I actually think that color. Could be used in here. A little bit of a wash. It's not really a white. Okay.
Hi, CP.
This opaque white helps cover the lines now that I'm just getting some of the In 2 second vices.
Well, she'll see it eventually.
I believe. All right. Oh, okay. It's not going to be much longer, and Patty's going to be on too. I know. So, I knew this wasn't going to be finished in one sitting. I just want to try to get the underpainting done. In the water. Let me put some dark in here. Just dry brush. All right, I'm thinking that I might use a, well, it's not a real rake. It's a rake that I took an old brush and cut into. It's hard to focus. I'm going to add a little bit of white to that gray and some brown. I'm going to take quite a bit of paint off my brush so I can just get the tips. Okay, I'm going to turn this so I can angle it. Kind of dry brushing over that, minimizing it. Grab some more white. All I'm going to turn it again. Grab some of that lighter gray. Go in the darker again. Now I'm gonna get a little water on that brush. Don't like that right in here, so I'm gonna minimize that. Just a damp brush, it's clean. Sorry, my head's in the way. Clean brush. Just trying to soften some of that. Come from it from upside down. Okay. This is the side that's light, so more. All right, I'm going to get more raw umber. More black, because now what I want to do is come through with a darker. Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna come in with the lighter again. Okay, now let's clean that brush off a little bit. Get the brown and the black. Let me get that wave kind of in there. Sorry, I'm not watching chat right now. All right, and then I need to get some of that lighter. Right on the shoulder. But then I'm going to come back in with the black and the brown. And minimize that. Bye, Kathy. Bye, CB. If Patty's come on, y'all just go on over to Patty's. No big deal. I'm going to finish up. I want to finish up what I'm doing. Why the paint's wet.
Okay. Okay. I think I'm ready for the background for the most part. So I'm going to get some Prussian blue. I keep moving because my I'll keep working with the brown and the black. Where his body would obviously be. I'm going to work in the blue in a minute. Let's get a little bit of texture down in here. Thank you, Josie. Like I said, I'm just going to finish the background while I have this paint wet. So y'all head on over to Patty's. I'm going to keep recording.
And then I'll be over there in a few minutes. Okay, now the Prussian blue. I need to get some of those brushes out of my hands. I think I'm gonna get a bigger brush. Got a little white to the light side. Just so I can show. Depth. Get some black. Worked in there in some places. More blue. In there. Thank you.
adding the black to the Prussian blue in areas. Just trying to get the highlights gone. Okay, and then I'm gonna add more. Raw umber, and I'm gonna get my trying to get that rake brush I made. Add some of that texture back in. Okay, just trying to add a little bit of right in here. And then this side's going to go black and blue. Oh, that was good. Put those back in the water. Okay, well, yeah, 3:30. So I still have time. I'm getting close to being done. Okay, more blue, more black. Okay, now I want to go back to that rake brush. Go on the black and the brown. Just giving some texture in here. Okay. I think the underpainting is done. Just here and there kind of stuff. Little lighter on the, I think, onto the, well, I say that, but this needs to be different. Needs more peach in there. Hi, Deb. The fur will get back in there. I think there's another finger that should be down in here. All right, I think I'm happy with it. Like I said, it's just an underpainting. Then I'll go in and finish the details with the colored pencil. Just looking for holidays right now in the paper, little white spots. Yeah, it's there is, but it's shadowed. One, two, three, four. See, it really should be shadowed up in here. There's a finger up in here. And you can't see his thumb. So I'm pleased, like I said, I'm pleased with my First pass. Now what I'll do is step away and let this dry and then come in and add colored pencil details. Now I won't color pencil the background. It'll just be the monkey. But I'm pretty pleased with the light. I have his face probably a little yellower in places, but the white colored pencil and the colored pencils will help with the adjusting some of the skin tone. But the paint will give me the grip. Oh, this is a shadow. Yeah, this is a shadow of this hand is shadowed. If that's what you mean right here, that's a shadow. And I'll probably need to go darker on this ear over in here. Definitely darker when I do the colored pencil because all the light is here and it's shadowed. So you can sort of see on the original that there's light kind of on this side. So that is it for me today. I just need to clean up all of this, put paints back. And like I said, most of the paints I use were the Deco Arts Traditions. And you'll see them either in this bottle, which is what I prefer, or they have them in the tubes. It's a little better grade acrylic. I think these are comparable to Liquitex Basics, just not quite as thick. And the book that we're working from, for those of you that came in late, was Painting Realistic Animals in Acrylic with Lee Hammond. And there were no step outs, so I just blew the monkey up. And then also, by the time you get it matted, let me wipe this off and I'll show you what it'll. I don't want to set the mat down or the picture down in this paint. So let me get this off and I'll show you what it will look like in the mat real quick. All right. I think we're safe there. Make sure there's nothing bad on my hands. So there's the monkey. And then when it's matted, it will be something like that. And I'll come in and work on the mouth and the teeth and all that with the colored pencils. All right, guys. Thanks, Deb. All right, guys, I'm going to go ahead and end the broadcast, and I'll see you over at Patty's in a little bit.